present. My name is Martti. I am in the NVScene. I'm known as Creature of Traction, as there are other groups, and I'm a lousy programmer. But that's why I'm here, because there are other sites to do on programming, except the technical stuff, and then this is what I'm going to be talking to you about today. So what I am going to be talking about is I'm going to be giving a small introduction to demo programming in general. Then I will be talking about ideas, and then I will be talking about different ways to actually bring those ideas on the screen with some examples of my previous work. Okay. So, demo programming, how many of you here are not familiar with demos in general? Anyone? Okay, a few people. Well, a demo is a non-interactive real-time show of visuals and audio and kind of a modern art form. They started in the 80s with 80s on computers. And nowadays they are being done on all kinds of modern platforms, from cell phones and modern computers to game consoles and also computers. Demo programming in general reminds a lot of game programming. Like, I'm a game programmer by trade. But this kind of game program is not the boring stuff. The demos are not interactive, so they are like just shows of visuals and effects and music. And anyway, more yet, the Batman stories are, they are dark, they are scary, most of the part, except the 60s one, but that doesn't really count. They cause more emotions to us. And my point with this thing is that I think that good or excellent storytelling is more about the abstract ideas and like making you feel something. And I think that very unfortunately very few demos do that, but I think those are the good ones. So about demo ideas, the demos and ideas in general. Usually demo scene visuals are very, very abstract, like for example in computer games you need to have this kind of environment which is very familiar to the player. For example, in Counter-Strike we have these buildings and houses and forests and whatever. But the demos are mostly abstract, so we have these very things that are not really not necessarily resemble things in real life, but they are more about computer art, like music videos and so forth. But there are actually a few storytelling demos. Most of them, to be honest, are not very good, because usually the people who make them kind of like try to do too much, and they end up comical maybe. But there are good ones as well. And as in all scenes, like art scenes or emo scene or whatever, there are these cliches and style which kind of define the scene, and so is in the demos. So in the 1980s and 1990s, the demos were usually pretty much the same, and the demos went through phases, which had like in the 1980s, you know, on the old computers, we had like scrollers and like certain kinds of effects, and when the demos moved to PCs and Amigas in the early 90s, the effects started being like 3D rotating objects and like small 3D worlds and things that take advantage of the hardware on those computers. And then nowadays demos are more about computer graphics in general, so you can actually see lots of the stuff that's in games you can see in demos, but there are still, like, for example, at this moment the number one demo scene cliche in productions is the bloom effect. You can see it in modern games, but like I think every single demo nowadays has bloom. Well, at least every single of my demos has. And in general, the demo scene is everybody's style is very open and allowing for all kinds of approaches and ideas. So the style that demos are produced in is very, very varied. So we have things like, I like making minimal techno stuff and like progressive rock things. Some people like doing drum and bass, like it's industrial things with robots. I know there are a few people here who like to do that. That's I'm talking about you. And we have from classical music to modern rock music to everything in the demos. So when you're implementing your ideas or your demos, you can do anything as long as people will like it. And of course some people do think people won't like, and I'm one of them, I'm proud of it. So in basic ways, basically there are three different ways to make an actual demo, which I line up here. First, you have an idea or a concept, and then you make a demo around it. For example, we might want to make demos about, let's say, trains. So you can start thinking that you might be building a 3D world with trains going on. Or you could want to, for example, one of my ideas, which I have not implemented yet, is I want to make a demo about futurism in the 20s and 30s, like how they will view the 20th century or the view back then. So I want to have these zeppelins and skyscrapers and like robots and all kinds of things that people wonder about them. Usually demos with these are storyboarded or concepted first, so you have concept art. and like maybe you try out a few things. Maybe you do, before you actually start making your own demo, you might do things with, for example, some 3D software and see how it looks. And then the other many way of doing a demo is just make something first. This is usually very easy for the programmer. So it's just like code something first. It might be a 3D engine, it might be a cool particle system effect, it might be, I don't know, some cool thing you found from a computer graphics paper, so implement it. And then you realize that this thing is actually, this might be really cool, so you want to make you want to like start tweaking around it to make it look cool. For example, one of the effects that people who are now doing demos nowadays is are the smoke simulators, or like fluid simulators. It's pretty complicated mathematically. They have been researched a lot more recently. So a friend of mine made this really, really, really basic fluid simulator thing, which is like you can use to simulate smoke. And then my friend started wondering about like how could he actually make it cool. So he started tweaking it. He added fire. He added water. And then he had like three or four different scenes with the fluid simulator. And then he added all kinds of other visuals on top of it. So basically the concept was the fluid, and all the scenes in the demo just exploited the concept. Actually, this demo has not been released yet. My friend said that he's working it for this party. I don't know if he has finished it. I hope so, because the previews were really cool. And this kind of make something first and then build a demo around it. This the general way of doing demos in NVScene. I think there are like some people, including me, use this method a lot, and it's kind of a personal preference. And of course, the third method of doing a demo is just like you do stuff and hope it will turn out okay. And unfortunately, many demos are done with this method. It might produce good things, might not. Usually, at least I have used this method as well. So I just like do stuff and then like somehow try to tie it together. And from the creative point of view, this is not really a good way of doing it, but you can manage. And ideas in general, like people make demos about what they like. So if you're into robots, you can make a robot demo. If you really like techno music, you can make techno demo like a VJ, in a VJ style or whatever. And like I have made over 40 productions, and I think my ideas that I have gotten are very varied. So I had this nightmare about this man who had whose head was made out of butterflies. It was really creepy, freaking nightmare. I couldn't sleep after that, but I decided to make a demo about it. I called it the Butterfly Thoughts. Was not really a good demo, but the idea was there. And of course, nowadays many people watch, for example, MTV and random music channels, and like music videos are filled with all kinds of cool stuff. So there are groups whose approach to making demos is very much like they take ideas from those things and like pop culture, and they put them on the screen. So whatever you find interesting is worth making a demo about. So now I'm going to talk about two of the demos that I have made. They are called Fiat Homo. This was released in assembly 2005, which is held in Finland, and Contraction from the Ultimate Meeting 2004, that was held in Germany. Now, these are both rather old compared. I have made like 20 demos since then, but I chose these two for the presentation because they are, in the visually, they are pretty similar, and they have this kind of same outlook on things, and I both also think that both of these are among my own personal favorites of the demos that I have made. Okay, so let's talk about Fiat Homo first. The concept that I had for it was human evolution, or the original concept. The name Fiat Verbum comes from a book. It's called A Canticle for Leibowitz. It's an old American science fiction novel from the 50s. So it's divided into three parts. It tells the story about a nuclear holocaust and like the resurrection of society after it. So the book is divided into three parts. There's Fiat Homo, let there be man. Fiat Lux, let there be light. And Fiat Voluntas Tua, which is like, let thy will be done. So that's one of the books that I have I read and I was when I was like 15, and I was really impressed by it, and it's left a permanent mark. So when I decided to do a demo about human evolution, I immediately knew that the Fiat Homo is the name I want to use for it. And the inspiration was that I was in Frankfurt in 2005, attending my first Breakpoint demo party in Germany. You should all go there, it's a fantastic place to be during the Easter. And I had some extra time off, so I went sightseeing. And then there's this place called Senckenberg Museum of Natural History, which is one of the largest in Europe. And there was this really awesome collection of fossils, like transitional fossils from like, I think it was rodent. And I thought that this would actually make like a really good demo or presentation, like having this thing morph from one face to another. So I decided I want to do a demo on that. And I wrote the first storyboard with it on a notebook. Unfortunately, I can't show it to you because the notebook was stolen on the airport. But it gave me an awesome chance to actually try out stuff and abandon some of the ideas that I had first. And also, another reason I wanted to do this demo because, well, back then, there still is this debate about intelligent design in the United States and also in Europe. And that's like a hobby of mine, following that stuff and a theory of evolution. So I wanted to express my personal thoughts about the topic in a form of a demo, an abstract way, but still. I think that many people don't use demos as vehicles for their own views and just concentrating on making stuff they think is cool. That's fine, but I think the demos can also be done to prove some points. And this production is a 64K intro, which is a demo that's restricted to 64 kilobytes in size. It's kind of an arbitrary restriction from the old times. But it offers unique challenges to actually like fit music and visuals in such a small size. And all things are generated procedurally. And before that, I had made only a couple of demos, and I wanted to do a 64K intro, so I decided that this would be an excellent project to try it out. So I'm now going through the entire intro, and I'm going to be telling about how I actually came up with this stuff. But my original storyboard contained ideas that are kind of impossible to actually, with my skill set, are kind of impossible to actually implement. So I decided to cheat and go the easy way and like keep the concept of evolution and like progression in the universe, but do it in a bit more, perhaps easier way. So the demo starts out with an explosion, like a big bang. So this is a very simple particle system. So it's just like a bunch of particles which are emanating from one point to fill the screen. And from there we go to the atoms. I tried some like actual visuals to like make the original parts glue on some quarks, whatever, diffuse into atoms, but that did not really work that well. It did not look good. So I just decided that I'd cheat again, and I will have the camera zoom into one particle and others will appear the atom. And I don't have a screenshot of this, but there's like this scene where there are more of these coming up, so basically it's kind of advancing.
Sorry to interrupt, we can run the intro if you want.
Sorry?
We can run the intro.
Can you?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, great.
Should we?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
I had originally a small Linux laptop which could not write even in the last slide, so I decided to show it, but that's awesome if you can.
Just a sec, the refresh rate was a bit exotic. It's your code, so.
Yeah, I know. I surely am a lousy programmer. Okay, right, that's good. see the original concept of the human evolution part, it really did not make it into the intro. And also the pixels were huge from up here. This is the first time I'm actually seeing this intro on a big screen because at the party place I had some other commitments, so I had to go. Well, anyway, this part is supposed to represent the molecules which kind of form after that explosion. And I wonder, what would actually be the one thing that kind of signifies life, like in this very primitive molecular way? Well, the obvious answer is the double helix of the DNA. So I coded this. It's, as you can see, it's like game programming, but except without the boring. And I know that everybody wants to be a game programmer, so you can just make demos instead. Okay, so thank you.